Hi guys, so I'm going to start with my coconut oil. I'm going to put it all over my face, moisturise my face before I put on any makeup. So I'm just going to pop it on. There we go. Try and get it as everywhere as I can, especially over my lips as well, because my lips get really dry too. And now I'm putting on the Urban Decay Primer Potion. Put this all over your eyelids. It will help with the eyeshadow stick. I'm going to put that on both of my eyelids to set them and prime them before I carry on with my shadow. Now I'm going to look for my eyeshadow brush, the one that I use all the time for my eyeshadows. It's quite old, to be fair, and it is quite stickly. I don't know what the hell happened there. But yeah, I'm going to be using the BH Cosmetics palette first. And there it is. Rather excited. So I'll be using that. The first colour I'm going to be using is like a purple colour. No, it isn't. It's a turquoise colour. The first colour I'm going to use is a turquoise colour. And I've just remembered that I want to put on my sellotape first around my eyes, so I'm just going to reach for it now. There it is. Pop a little bit on each of my eyes, just where I kind of want the angle to be for my eyeshadow. Usually go along the bottom lash line and kind of follow it up. I don't know what I've done there. I think I've got some eyeshadow on my hand. Checking if it looks correct. It needs to be barely even on each side. You can't have it too out of place. Pop them on there. Now we're ready to go. Now I'm gonna be starting to put the colour on the inner corners of my eyes. I'm gonna do that on both eyelids, so I'm gonna speed this bit up, and so yes, keep watching. Now I'm going to wipe off the excess and then go into the second colour, which is going to be like a lime green. You can't see it too well on the camera, but it is a nice lime green. I'm going to pop that into the centre of my eyes on both lids. Not going too far high up, but just in the middle, following that line that we started with the Turk. Okay, so now I'm going to wipe off the excess of the lime green that we just used, and then go in with a shadow pot from Robin McCatchell's Oh My Glitter. She has some amazing colours, and I think the one that I'm going to be using is Mania. It's like a hot pink. Yes it is Mania. It is really buttery and shimmery and absolutely gorgeous. So I'll be using that on the outer corners of my eyes and bringing them up over where the lime green is, and a touch into the Turk, just slightly, so it's not too heavy, but definitely heavy on the outside where that sellotape is. So now I'm going to go back to the BH Cosmetics palette, and I'm going to look for a shade that I can use near the upper corners of my eyes, where my eyebrows are. I'm going to look for something that kind of blends everything together. And I think I go for a lovely purple. I do go for a lovely purple. And I will be popping that on and discovering that it is the same colour as, or very similar colour to Robin McCatchell's. So I'm not exactly impressed, as you can see, but I go with it and we will figure out what to do next in a moment. So as you can see, I am literally just blending that out a little bit lower down towards where the Turk is. So you've got that kind of full eye, trying to avoid any kind of spots or white areas. Now that I've done that, I'm going to go in with my highlighter. I'm first buying my highlighter brush. It's really small, it's quite compact, but it works wonders for the inner corners of your eyes. There it is. It's not from anywhere fancy, guys. I don't buy fancy brushes. Probably from Wish, more than likely. This is a Unicorn Heart from iHeart Makeup, Tam Beauty, aka Makeup Revolution. I've done a whole review on it on my page. The colour that I'm going to be going for is the blue on the inside. You don't need a lot. Literally, you can see how much I'm using. Pop it there on the arch of my eyebrow. And I'm actually quite surprised at how well it's blending in. It has a lovely shimmer to it, so when it does blend in, it looks amazing. And it went quite well with that purple I put on earlier on. So I put that on both of my eyebrows, well, underneath my eyebrows, and then I'll be putting on in the corners of my eyes. Now I am reaching for my glitter tray. Got all my little glitters in here, as you can see. Look at them, pretty glitters. I have my glitter glue in there as well. It is from eBay and it is just fixed gel glue. You get like four little tubs for about £4, £5, something like that. But they're really good, and I think they are better than eyelash glue, because eyelash glue, although it sticks really well, it is a nightmare to get off. This is a lot more better. Just trying to figure out which colour to use. I wasn't 100% sure. I thought I'd go with a light blue, but ended up going with a lovely yellow. So I'm just going to pop that on and use the wand just to create a kind of curve, and just try and get it as even as possible on each eye, so it looks a bit like a wing, but not overdo it. Now I'm going to go in with my black liquid liner. Now this is from Primark. Basically what I do is I buy the cheapest eyeliner I can find and usually use a really long paintbrush to put it on with. I don't think you need to spend loads and loads of money on eyeliner just for a paintbrush that you could buy in a set from the works for about £3. So I try and put it on. I didn't want a really thick line, I wanted like a decent finish line. Something noticeable, but nothing too heavy. And the Celtic works wonders for this, because I'm not really paying too much attention to what I'm doing, especially with the wing itself. But yeah, I'm going to carry on doing that on both eyelids. Now it's the fun part. Now I'm going to take off the sellotape and see how sharp the line has come. I'm pretty sharp, pretty happy with that. So it looks pretty good. You don't have to put too much effort into it. It makes life so much more easier, and off they pop into the bin. As I got so much fallout of glitter and eyeshadow, I'm going to use my Johnson's Gentle All Over Baby Wipes. and wipe off the excess all over my face. Thankfully, I've not done my foundation yet. Best thing to do is always do your eyeshadow first, then put your foundation on, because then you're not wiping the foundation. See how much excess there is. Especially with glitter as well, glitter is a nightmare to get off. So always best not to have any kind of foundation on first. A lot of people do it differently. This is the way I do it, and this is the way I've been doing it for ages, and it works wonders for me. So try and clean up as best as possible. Okay, now I'm going to go for my brow pencil. It is again from Primark, and it is a 3-in-1 eyebrow pencil, and I'm literally going to outline my eyebrows in this pencil. Try and do it as best as I can. It doesn't have to be really neat. I'm not really a big fan of extremely like neat eyebrows. Try and fill it in a little bit. My eyebrows are a little bit thin, and this is in medium brown. So I use that just to kind of define the arch and stuff and make it as clear as I can. I don't have much of a curve near the inside of my eyebrows either, so I'll try and fill it in a little bit. Next I'm going to be going in with my eyebrow gel, which is from Maybelline. It's Brow This Way, and that again is in medium brown. Put that over it just to kind of keep the eyebrows down and keep them a little bit shaped. And that looks fine to me from here. Now it's time for mascara. I use the Maybelline Colossal. This is my favourite mascara ever. And I always find that it went clumpy once. So the best thing I did was put some eyebrow solution into it. Contact lens solution into it. And it sorted itself out. It was back to being normal again without any clumps, without being too dry. And I think that's a really good tip to have. Now it's foundation time. So we've got Match Perfection foundation in creamy beige. I only put in 2 small pumps, don't need too much. And that is a Real Techniques brush. Is it a Real Techniques? Have a look. Yes, it is. It is a Real Techniques brush. Use that to go all over my face with. And then I'll be going in with powder. Powder that I'm using is from Collection 2000, and it is a sheer loose powder. It's called Barely There. It's really good. I think it's brilliant. Again, with a non-branded brush. And I don't slap it on. I put on as little as I can. I don't do the whole baking thing. I don't do any of that. I literally just put on powder to kind of set my foundation. I'm sorry, I'm watching this with you guys, so I'm literally just kind of watching what I'm doing. And now it's time for contour. I'm using the Sunkissed, I'm not sure what it's called, Sunkissed Bronzer. I have a very small brush, and I'm not sure exactly where it's from. I think it's Maybelline Fit Me. I think the brush came with the little box. And I just literally contour my cheekbones. Yes, it is like a very credit card contour, but I like it like that, especially with my headscarf. Contour my jawline to get away from that hideous double chin that I have. And I will contour my forehead because I have a 4-finger forehead. And I will try and do it as best as I can. My scarf is never that high. The only reason I've done it that high is because for the video I want people to be able to see where I put my foundation and stuff. And now I'm going in with a very thin brush to do my nose contour. There is no real technique here. Literally go down the sides and blend it out as best as you can. Always curve the bottom so it doesn't look like your nose goes on forever. Now I'll be going in with my highlighter, my lovely, lovely highlighter, if I can find it. It is a strobe highlighter from Makeup Revolution in Flash. It has a lovely kind of like green look to it. If you look in the light, it looks almost green and a little bit. I use this pretty much every single day. I never put on too much on my nose, but I will see what it looks like today. Always on the cupid's bow. And a lot of people say to me, why don't you wear lipstick? So I thought for this video I should wear some lipstick. So I got my I think it's Maybelline. Yes, it's a Maybelline it's Maybelline Color Drama Intense Velvet Lip Pencil in, what is the colour? Can't find the colour. Well, I literally put it all over. Cleaning up sides. If I find the colour, guys, I will let you know, but I can't seem to find it right now. clean up my nose stud. Nose ring. And I think we're pretty much done. Oh, you can add eyelashes if you want to, but for this look, I didn't bother. Thank you for watching and take care.